busy as a bee. You can see this coffee tree is already starting to flower, and the bees have already started to find it. I picked cherries off of this tree about a week ago and left the green ones, and you can see some of the green ones are already starting to turn red. The crop is mostly gone from this season, and the tree has already started, as you can see up here, started flowering for next season's crop, and the bees have already started to find it. In a few weeks, the whole farm is going to be covered with flowers like this, and the bees will be very busy, and you'll be able to hear them. And I mean, hear them from a distance at all hours of the day. And all that pollination makes for good honey, and it makes for good coffee, because once they pollinate, then you're going to get next year's crop of coffee cherries. So some of these trees still have more picking to do for this season's crop, this year or this season's crop, and at the same time they're now flowering for next season's. And that's a good productive tree even if it can pull that off, flower and fruit at the same time. Here's where most of the bees live. Down at the bottom of the property, we've got this area set aside with beehives, and a local beekeeper comes and maintains this. It's a real win-win situation because he'll pay a small amount of rent for the land area he has here, and he provides us with free honey. And his busy bees are busy pollinating all the coffee trees. And that can be important when you've got as many flowers as a big coffee orchard is going to have. There would be literally millions of flowers. Since all of the coffee cherries start out as coffee flowers, it's important to have some good pollinators like these bees somewhere on the property. The better the pollination, the bigger the crop you're going to get.